welcome to Centre Court, all thanks to TAC. Well, the grand final has been played and it has been won by the New South Wales Swifts. It was a huge game on the weekend. Ash Braz, what did you think of the granny?
Thought it was awesome, V, but what I loved is we both picked the Swifts. So I'm pretty proud of us. Poor little Louis was a little bit upset that he didn't get the win, but Mum holds bragging rights, so pretty happy about it.
Well, I am glad that you're more of an expert than your son at this moment in time, after all the research that you do. Now, I know it's no surprises to anybody who our guest on the show is today, because thank you to all of your questions that you have all sent in. And just here is our handle, just for one last time, at Centre Court Show and hashtag Centre Court Netball for anything that you want to communicate to us. And it's been great having you every episode join in, and we've certainly got some questions coming up for Maddy Proud, the co-captain, now Premiership player with the New South Wales Swifts. So it's now time for The Agenda, thanks to TAC. Make safety features a priority in your next car. Visit howsafeisyourcar.com.au. We thought we might as well go to the girl herself. She had an incredible game, and we've also heard a lot about she was playing under an injury cloud. We didn't know any of this before a game, and probably quite clever to keep it under wraps as well. Maddy Proud, congratulations and thanks for joining us on Centre Court.
Thank you guys. Thank you for having me. It's not only the broken rib, but it's now the broken throat as well. So the voice is a little bit husky. Hopefully you can still hear me.
Because you can actually still celebrate and enjoy yourselves up in Queensland at the moment, which is good to see.
Yes, we were very excited. Actually, I think it was the Friday night before the grand final that they announced that dancing was back. So dance we did.
That is the priority, V. Like, we think that she's lost her voice from all the cheering and all that, but it's definitely the partying.
Yeah.
And there is like, we've got it here.
We've got
Sophie Garvin just doing what she does best.
Sophie Garvin things.
Oh, there with Nat Cook. And then we saw, with Patty Mills. Can you explain what happened after the grand final that this eventuated and you started partying with the Olympians?
Well, we all said we wanted to spin the story that Patty asked for a photo with us, but that wasn't quite the case. But no, there's a few mutual friends between some of the other basketball players back in Sydney. So Paige Hadley knew Jason Cadee, who plays for the Bullets here in Brisbane, and then happened to be that we're at the same place. And Patty was there. So we definitely heckled him for a little while to ask for a photo, but no, he was great value. And then to have Nat Cook there as well, she'd actually spoken to us a bit throughout the week and actually throughout the season when we'd been in Brizzy. She'd come and sort of shared her story and kind of inspired us on a few occasions. So we're very lucky to have her there as well.
And actually, I wanted to ask you, how come Paddy, after what, 2 weeks of quarantine that he's done since the Olympics, is still in uniform, still wearing his medal?
I know. That was one of the first things I asked him, because I went to hold up my medal and I didn't even realise that he had his as well. So mind you, I don't think I'll be taking mine off for a little while. I can't believe I've left it right now. I've usually haven't parted from it the last few days.
Who was best on forms, Mads? Because I did see a few of the players actually had Paddy Mills hats on, so
I would have tried to steal that hat.
I couldn't believe that hat was getting passed around, because I don't think he'd see it off his head. But yeah, for you, Mads, who was best on ground for your team?
You can always guarantee that Sophie Garvin's just going to go rogue and do Sophie Garvin things. We did say Loz Moore, though. She was repping some Miley buns and was ripping up the dance floor. So I think everyone sort of came out of the woodwork on Saturday night and had their moments of glory. So, no, it was very exciting. We obviously have been sort of cooped up for a long time, and to be able to kind of get out and do it in under the circumstances of celebrating was very, very fun.
Okay, let's get to some more serious questions. And as we said, our fans from our netball family on Twitter have sent in some. We're going to start with this one from Scott. He said, awesome effort to play with a broken rib. When did you find out that it was broken? And obviously, after missing the 2019 grand final, we don't want to keep harping on that, but was that in the back of your mind in the lead up that, is there a chance I might not be able to play in this one?
Yeah, well, so it sort of got broken in the last minute, literally. I reckon it was 60 or 90 seconds of the semi-final when I had that collision with Matilda McDonald. And originally sort of in that, bump or whatever it was, I was a bit worried about my head. I sort of thought I got a hit to the head and a hit to the side, but wasn't too worried about the side, and kind of was only a bit nervous that I was going to be concussed or something like that. So as soon as I sort of passed the scat test, I was cheering. And then it wasn't until I sort of went to move around a bit that I knew something wasn't quite right in down my side. And again, we still didn't think it was broken just because I was in a lot of pain, but I thought that I would have been in a lot more pain if it had been broken. And obviously probably was trying to convince myself more than anyone that it wasn't. So it wasn't until a couple of days later when I still wasn't moving too well that the physio and doctor sort of said it's probably worth getting an x-ray. And there were a lot of conversations, I guess, in relation to missing the game. I sort of said, look, I don't really want to know what it is if it's something that can stop me from playing. And they sort of assured me that, I guess, no matter the outcome, we'd find a way. And, yeah, there was definitely some moments, especially in that first week afterwards when I could barely move, that I was sort of thinking, how the hell am I going to actually be able to play a game in netball? But, yeah, so lucky to have that extra week, that little bit time, more time to rest definitely helped. And got an injection before the game to give it a bit of numbing, but also managed to have lots of physio and everything like that. So it was pretty good to go in the end.
Well, we've talked about one of your favourite teammates already a fair bit, Sophie Garvin. We saw on Twitter that there was no sympathy. She talks about how many ribs you have left. You've got 23, so we don't know why you're complaining. Did any of your team actually give you sympathy? Because I don't know, for me looking in, if I knew that you had a broken rib before the game, I would feel so bad for you knowing you're going up against Jamie Lee Price. She's someone that you know is going to go for the ball. Both of you are like that. You're on the ground a lot. Was there any sympathy before the game, or is that what you copped the whole week?
No, well, thankfully the teammates were actually quite sympathetic. They obviously, again, knowing the backstory of 2019, and I think as well they sort of probably thought I was a bit dramatic that first night after the game when I'm barely moving, and then it wasn't until they did find out that it was broken that they all sort of started to be like, okay, maybe we should have been a bit nicer to Maddy the last few days. But no, they were all awesome, and it was kind of that fine line as well though between not making it a focus because I obviously didn't want to be a distraction or anything like that, so we sort of just got on with the job. But there was a bit of time when Sam Wallace sort of missed out on a few training sessions that last week as well, but we were sort of able to bounce off each other. And I think anytime she went to complain, she's like, I don't have a broken rib, I'm gonna be okay. At least it wasn't my leg, so no, it was they're all very good.
So for the people at home that don't know Mads, like, obviously you talked about getting an injection, is there anything else? Did you have to have strapping on it, or did you just go, well, let's just play?
Yeah, so that was sort of a bit of the conversation as well about the week leading into the game, because I obviously wanted to be able to train mainly for sort of my own sanity, but also for obviously the team as well. And there was a bit of, I guess, uncertainty as to whether I'd actually be able to do that without having an injection. But luckily, just a few sort of painkillers, Panadine Fort, things like that, were able to get me through the training week. So then when it came to the actual game, I knew that I'd been able to train sort of without this injection. So obviously having the injection was going to make me feel even better. But they pretty much just inject a local anaesthetic right into the bone, which sounds sort of weird. But I think I was so high in adrenaline that I honestly didn't even really notice it was happening. And then it all happened. I had to get it done literally. Like, I missed the team meeting because they can run out pretty quickly and they wanted to make sure it sort of lasted as long as possible. So I had to sprint out of the team meeting, lie on this bed, get the doctor to do it, and then pretty much just run out onto the court to go and warm up. So I think that kind of worked to my advantage, not having time to worry about it. But then, yeah, had some pretty intense strapping on it. It was sort of wrapped all the way around me to the point where at halftime I had to say to the physio, I think we need to loosen it a little bit because I'm not worried about my ribs. I'm just worried if I can actually breathe for the rest of the game.
Oh, wow. So much goes into it, and very clever to keep it all a secret, I think, as well. Now, we've got another question from Fran. Now, she's talking about internationals and knowing that we've got upcoming tests, you're in the squad. Does it give you more confidence, especially the Swifts players are in the squad, knowing that you've been able to win SSN now?
Oh, I think it's anything like that. When you know that sort of our team's in good form, or individually you're in good form, of course, it gives you more confidence. And I've always been a big believer in if you perform well within your team and that's the sole focus, then the rest will take care of itself. And we obviously are able to have a great, particularly end to the season. So there'll be confidence there for sure. I think, you know, you look at all the Swiss players that are in that Aussie squad, like Maddy Turner obviously getting the MVP of the grand final. I think Sarah Cloud's had her best season yet. You then got Paige Hadley and Sophie Garvin as well. So I think they've all had probably their best seasons ever. So again, there's already so many other athletes as well and players that have done so well that didn't happen to make the grand final that, you know, will be just as confident as we are. But I think, yeah, definitely go in there with that extra little bit knowing that you've been able to take home the trophy.
So what do the next couple of weeks look like for you, Mads, heading into the Diamonds camp? You're obviously in Queensland now. I'm assuming you can't go home. So what does it look like for you?
Yes, no, that's what I said. Just try and stay clean for as long as possible before you go to the Aussie camp. So we're all just going to hang around here in Queensland. We're actually going to go to the Gold Coast. We've been based in Brisbane, so we thought we'd like to sort of feel like we're on a little bit of a holiday, but also keep training. So they've very nicely given us this week off just to celebrate, relax and enjoy this week. And then it's, no sort of rest for the wicket and get back into a bit of training next week before, hopefully heading into camp around that 14th of September time. But again, you know how quickly things can change at the moment, so you're sort of not holding your breath and you're just taking it day by day for now, which I'm sure you guys are in a similar boat with that.
Now, how did all your family, how did everybody cope? Although I assume your family went, because are they in South Australia? But how is the rest of just all the fans knowing that they're all in New South Wales and couldn't actually be at the game with you?
Yeah, well, that was a little silver lining for me, was that my parents were able to come. My parents and Maddie Turner's parents both came over as well. I think as soon as that border got open, my parents booked their flights, even thinking that they might have had to quarantine going back to Adelaide. But luckily, the borders opened both ways sort of in the week leading into that game. So, they were, you talk about family and their support, and I guess everything that happened in 2019, they go through that as well, probably even more so than you do when it's happening to yourself. So I guess when we won that trophy, it was as much for them as it was for me. But also really, really hard for the fans back home in Sydney not to be there, and just knowing how much support they showed us throughout the whole season. It was pretty heartbreaking to not have them in the crowd, but we also knew that we had so much to play for in that game, and we had so many lovely messages from them back in Sydney, sort of saying that we were the highlight of their lockdown, and to kind of bring a little bit of light to their day on Saturday was, that was pretty special.
Oh, no doubt you were. Now, we've also had your social media guru, Maddy, on our show because we love what she does. She's always hilarious, and she also speaks to us a lot and tweets a lot about you being on the floor. And we've got this question from Libby, and she talks about how does she feel about how many times you hit the deck. Does it play on your mind? Do you worry about it? Or is it just comical amongst you and your teammates?
It's sort of become a bit of a joke now. There's been a few times where it's like, okay, the ones where I trip over my own feet, like, we probably need to do something about that. And that's maybe a bit of a biomechanical thing and something we can try and work on in the gym. But the other ones, the girls actually always say to me, they say they reckon that I have my best game when I'm hitting the deck more times than I'm not, because they think that means that I'm going for the ball and I'm in the play. But it is something that, you obviously don't love spending time on the floor, and especially with a broken rib. The doctor pretty much said to me, you'll be fine as long as you don't fall over. And we sort of joked about the fact that, did she know who she was talking to. So I think that, as long as I'm getting the ball and I'm involved in a contest, then I'm happy to be on the floor. And I think sometimes it's almost a habit in a way that you're kind of going for it. And now that it happens so much, it just happens when it probably shouldn't. But maybe the beauty of growing up with two brothers in the backyard and kicking the footy with them, that you always knew you just had to dive on the ball to try and get it. So I'll try and aim to stay on my feet a little bit more next season.
It just shows, Mads, that you were just in the contest all the time. But is there a player that you know coming up against that you've got to be on the ground more often than not? Because I know, playing, I think, all right, this game's going to be tougher, but do you actually have moments where you're like, all right, I might break my rib this game?
I think, Jess Anderson and I always just seem to get tangled amongst one another. I think that she's very closely, I think she could even be in front of me some games, the amount that she hits the deck, and our sort of falls just seem to be the most uncoordinated and who knows what's going on. But then obviously Jamie Lee, she's obviously a real physical player and is so strong that I know that, if we're both going for a ball, I'm probably going to be the one that comes off second best. But I think any time that there's two players going for the ball, someone's going to have to end up second best. And I probably just need to make sure that I can try and be on the receiving end or giving end of a few more of those falls rather than, getting them all the time myself.
Now, as a captain of the team, I'm sure you have many moments where you see players do things that you either don't expect, or you just get this pride in seeing them actually achieve something and doing something great. And is there any player out there on the court that was, or even on the bench, that really impressed you this season far beyond what you thought that they were capable of?
The first person that probably comes to mind is Taylor Fraser. I think for her, traditionally being a wing attack, swinging into centre, starting the year playing a little bit of wing attack, a little bit of centre, and then sort of finding her way into a starting seven wing defence position, probably just sums up the type of player she is, that she's just willing to do absolutely anything she can to be on the court and to do her job for the team. And I think that she really developed her game, and the way that her and Loz Moore were able to share that position, I think was pretty smart from Bryony, in terms of you had the Taylor that's that real dogged, she'll just go hard for everything and she'll wear down a player, and then Loz Moore can come on and do what she did in that semi-final where she's on for 2 seconds and takes an intercept. So I think the two of them and the way that they were able to play that position, and I've talked about it a little bit this week as well, but Loz Moore was in the same position as I was in 2019. She had a shoulder recon just before the grand final, and we've been through that journey together for the last few years. So to see her be able to take the court on Saturday was that pretty special, and to be able to share that moment with her as well made it even more special.
Yeah, Maz, and two players that B and I have talked about a fair bit. Like, we've loved watching Tay and Lauren. They've been unbelievable. Mm. And it's great that you mentioned that Tay is a wing attack, because you would not know the way she plays wing defence. Another player I want to talk about is Maddy Turner, obviously getting MVP of the game. She had a ripper game. A lot of people probably didn't notice how much work she had to put in to stop the goal attack. But was that a big plan coming into this game?
Yeah, I think Maddy Turner's really one of the most underrated players in the league. I think that she just goes about her business, and we sort of joked about the fact that she didn't get an MVP the entire season and then pulls it down in the grand final. But it probably shows that, you know, the stats might not always, you know, point in her favour, but you then have to really look at the stats of the person she's playing against to realise what she's really doing. And I think she definitely nullified Sophie Dwyer in that game. And I think Sophie's been such a standout this entire year, and we know how much she can, you know, open up that Giants front line. So it was just a matter of Maddy not giving her any breathing space, you know, really making her work hard and kind of breaking that connection that she does have with Joe. Because I think when her and Joe are on, they can be the sort of most formidable goal circle in the whole league. So I just think that she's so unassuming. She just goes about her business, and she's not there for sort of all the individual accolades or anything like that. She's just there to do what she can do for the team. And I even think the work that she did in attack on Saturday as well was huge for the team. So the ultimate team player, and that definitely, you know, the fact that she was able to get that reward in that game just was incredible.
Yeah, I agree. And I love the fact that, you know, her stat sheet wasn't enormous, but it's all that stuff that goes on behind the scenes. And Sarah Clough might get all the intercepts, but it's the work that she's doing at the front. That...
But also be a defender got MVP.
I know. That was
mind blown, guys.
Like cheering it on. Oh, so great to see. All right, we've got a question from Zara for you, because I don't know if you know, and I'm sure you wrote a book, Maddy.
What?
Grace on Court. Now, when's number two coming out?
Oh, this has been a really tough thing, is that I've actually had the book written. Grace on the Court 2 has been written for about 2 years. I've just actually really struggled to find a publisher. I had a few issues with the publisher who did Grace on the Court 1, and then it's taken a long time to try and find someone that's willing to sort of release the second book in a series when the first one's already out with a different publisher. So I've sort of changed literary agents. I've got a new manager now as well. So we're really working hard to make sure it gets out there. And sort of every time I think I'm just going to pull the trigger and self-publish, I sort of get told to just be a little bit more patient, and anyone that knows me knows I'm not very patient at all, so it's been eating away at me. But people need to know that it is finished, it will come soon, but yeah, just want to make sure I do it right and do it properly, so just got to be a little bit more patient for now.
Smart move. And before we let you go, there was a lot of conversation on Twitter that Emmy was asking you, can you explain what she's talking about when, was it Jelena and who?
Jaylee. So Jelena and Jaylee. So that's Justin Bieber and Selena Gomez, their couple name.
Okay.
Or Justin Bieber and Hailey. Well, she was Hailey Baldwin, but now she's Hailey Bieber. So she's asking me who I prefer, because a lot of the traditional Beliebers are all for Justin and Selena. But then, you know, now he's married to Hailey. So I'm just going to have to go on the fence here and say whatever makes him happy. If Hailey's the person that makes him happy, they're now married. You know, they're obviously very good for each other. They seem very, very happy. So, as long as he's happy, I'm happy. So, Emmy.
Boring.
She's playing nice. She's waiting for the phone call. I'm still available,
yeah,
guys.
I'm waiting.
Oh, that is so good. I just love the banter that you see between the players and the fans on Twitter. It's great. Thank you so much for joining us, Maddy. Congratulations again on being the 2021 Premiers, and all the best for what's to come with the Diamonds.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Mads.
That was the agenda, thanks to TAC, How Safe Is Your Car? It's now time to get to the nitty-gritty, thanks to Lexus of Berwick, your hybrid destination of choice. Visit lexusofberwick.com.au. Braz, I want to talk to you about some breaking news that has just literally happened just before we have started filming. Hot off the press. Christiana Manua and Binion Hunt have both said and announced that they're going over to Pulse over in New Zealand to play in the ANZ Premiership. What do you make of that news?
Well, you're breaking it to me because I had absolutely no idea. I think it's smart. I think for Chrissy especially, like she has been in the Diamond squad before. We all know she can play. She was injured last year. She's come back. But obviously April Branley has just been playing amazing netball. So we saw a lot of Chrissy on the bench this year. And, you know, it doesn't matter how old you are, you want to play netball. So I'd be thinking she's going over there to really get court time. But yeah. Do both of them, are they Australian citizens or can they play both? Are they?
Well, that's a very interesting point. And what I believe is that Binion Hunt was born in Australia. However, I think her parents or one of her parents, so she's got an Australian and a New Zealand passport, and Chrissy was actually born in New Zealand and came over to Australia, so she obviously is eligible to play for the Silver Ferns as well. I want to know, I think what I would love to find out is this Nolene Tarua, let's go and get these players and bring them across and let them play in our competition and see if we can, if you know they will be eligible and if we can have them in the Silver Fern squad. Because if so, I think it's a really clever move by New Zealand to take some of the players. We saw Binion Hunt get some court time, especially this year, and she is a really strong wing attack. She is almost, you can see her slotting into the Silver Ferns, maybe not right now, but certainly in the future.
And I think traditionally she's a goaler. So to have a goaler that can play wing attack's massive. I got to play against her this year and she was a wing attack. She is such a strong body and she's just a beautiful person. But I think what's great for Binny is, like you said, Knowles knows her. Knowles has coached her in the Sunshine Coast. So I don't know. Maybe you're right, V. She's calling it pretty early. Look out, Com game.
Well, I just think it is a very clever move. And we know that there must be, as soon as the contracts are signed, is there any update on that? Do you have any
information? No, and I think that's why I find it interesting because they are 100% just picking the New Zealand League over the Australian League. There's been no talk about when we can sign our contracts. Hopefully it's soon. You know, you're hearing all these rumours. Sounds like it's close. But, yeah, that they've made that choice to go to New Zealand. So massive call, but I think it'll be great for their career. So good luck to them both.
Well, I think we should definitely do an episode of Centre Court. Maybe we should be like, this should be the trade table and we just, it's all happening live and we're chatting to all the coaches and the recruiters.
Actually, I reckon we should do that.
I think we should absolutely do that. Well, hopefully.
Who knows when it starts though? Because the players don't even know when the contracts start.
No, we might have to hold off a couple of weeks until we know. But I say let's just have an actual round table discussion with all the people that are picking these players and see who they're listing and make sure that we have all of those that up-to-date information for you. But some other up-to-date information that you might not have seen or you may have recently is all the best and fairest from the clubs are starting to be named, especially the teams that are having to do Zoom online best and fairest events. Here's the first one. So no surprises there. Sam Wallace, she was absolutely unbelievable in the grand final. Joe Harton as well. I don't think that's any surprise that she is the MVP at the Giants. Kate Maloney, it gets confusing because you think Sherelle McMahon, but no, Sherelle McMahon medal and Kate Maloney won that for the Vixens. And Jodie Ann Ward, I thought this was not necessarily a surprise, but I loved seeing her win that. She has taken so many intercepts this season and she is a really small goal defence. When Jamaica don't even really consider her as a circle defender, they'll put her in the midcourt if she's playing for Jamaica. Yet you guys, you have her in the circle and she's really been dominant this season.
Oh, she's unbelievable. And not just, I guess, her, but the combination of her and Jeeva. They just know how to work off each other, read the ball really well. But the big thing for me with Jodes is her improvement from last year to this year is just next level. For me, seeing the growth, obviously I wasn't with them last year, but her capability to run out 60 minutes this year has gone through the roof. We obviously saw her last year coming in and out of the game and with the change over, we're able to get her off and bring her back on, where she played a lot of court time this year. And the fact that she got the amount of intercepts she did, she's just a freak of an athlete. Like half the time I don't even know what she's doing, but she's got the ball in her hand. So, yeah, she's one player that I love playing with and I hope I'm helping her with her journey, but she's definitely helping me change my game up as well.
And we know, well, we're used to having big events when it's a best and fairest night for the clubs. What's it like having them on Zoom? You had yours, was it last night?
Yeah, it was terrible. See, it is, I'm not a fan. It's so sad that, you know, we were with each other the whole time in the COVID lockdowns. We were travelling state to state, pretty much running away from COVID to get this season done. We spent a lot of time with each other, and the fact that we couldn't actually hang out with each other and celebrate the season we had, it's pretty hard. And I'm so glad and grateful that the Swifts and the Giants are still able to stay up in Queensland and celebrate, I guess, their season that they've had. But we lost to Fever in our last round, and the next day we were on a flight home. So couldn't celebrate anything. And to then see that, I think it's great that we could do it. So well done to all clubs that are still doing it online. But just so hard that I guess we couldn't celebrate with Joes and give her a hug at the end of it and just be around it to celebrate what an awesome year the team have had in growth, but then also what Jodie put out on the table as
well. Yeah, but I actually think the fans really appreciate that they can join in as well and they can watch and be a part of it. And I know I tuned into the Vixens and it was actually quite fun to watch it and see it play out. It's a much quicker format. The one thing that was very funny though about the Vixens was that Simone was, you know, in typical Zoom style, she was talking, then put herself on mute and then was still talking. And it was just one of those moments that you're like, ah, good old 2020.
Kate Maloney did tell me about how funny it was. And I think the difference between ours and Vixens is Vixens was live, which I really like because you can see the errors and that makes it entertaining. Ours was pre-recorded. We actually didn't have any of those mix-ups, which was amazing. But like I said, it's great that we can get it done. It's awesome for the fans. It's awesome for, I guess, not just fans, but anyone can watch it. I think that's the difference between being in a club doing it. Like, your fans can still come to your presentation. I like that because we actually get to meet people.
Of course.
But then, like, I could have jumped on the Vixens one.
You could have.
That's just...
You could have.
Maybe I might jump on someone else's if they do it just to
I did
up.
Like too, because you could have, like, if you're watching on YouTube, you could have the comments on the side. So people, just random people bantering on the side as the event's going on.
Were you joining in?
No, I was not. I was just actually laughing my way through it. Anyway, let's get back to netball chat. And the Diamonds put out this tweet yesterday talking about Caitlin Bassett. And that they will, well, she is going in to have knee surgery. She's staying in Perth at the moment with her family. We know she's not going back to New Zealand and we're still waiting to hear if she will be picked up by a Super Netball team. But no Caitlin Bassett for the Diamonds. And we know that the squad, there's actually not that many shooters in the squad. I think there's four now that aren't injured that are eligible. So does that mean they're automatic starters?
You'd think so, wouldn't you? No, a big shock for me. Like, I don't think any of us in the squad realised that Bass's knees were that bad. She had to have surgery, so good on her for getting it done. Bass is just in the news, isn't she? We all want to know where she's going. Hopefully her knees are all right and we can still see her back in the green and gold. But, yeah, it was massive news for me. Hopefully we do still see her in camp because I think her experience, especially for this young group, would be massive to have her courtside.
Yeah, okay. So can you give us a bit of an insight exactly what's happening? So with the Diamonds coming up, there's a squad camp which is happening in Perth, is that right?
Yep. So in 2 weeks we'll be heading to WA. Hopefully there is plan A, plan B, plan C, plan D. I'll give you plan A.
Okay.
Because who knows what will happen, but we're hoping that we can get to Perth. We can isolate for our 2 weeks and hopefully still train under the WA rules and guidelines. I'm assuming in that time in our camp, the selectors will pick the squad, the team, which would be the 15, and then they will be playing the England Roses.
In three games that are happening in Perth?
Yes.
Yep.
So massive for England though. Like, obviously, we heard from Maddy, they're staying in Queensland so they can still get to WA. They're obviously not allowed to go home. But what England have done, and which is incredible, is they're now currently isolating in New Zealand, hoping to play New Zealand. So they still don't know if they'll play New Zealand just because of the lockdowns.
Right.
So what they had to do is fly from England to Singapore, Singapore to New Zealand, because they couldn't get in any other way. What Jeeva and I'm assuming Stacey Francis had to do is fly from Australia to Singapore all the way back to New Zealand. So massive trips. I think full credit to England. Like, they've just gone, let's do it. We don't know if it's going to pull off, but they're taking a risk and then they're coming over to play us. So I just think the fact that they're willing to get on a plane not knowing what tomorrow brings them is just unbelievable, and full credit to all the girls, but also the coaching staff.
Yeah, and also not knowing how many weeks of quarantine they might have to do going from New Zealand, then trying to get over to Perth. And yeah. Will you have to quarantine if you go into WA?
Yes, everyone does. Yep. So and the 2 weeks. We're all together as a team. So that will be good. Good bonding time when you can't leave the hotel. And it's full lockdown. Like, it's not... we can't go out like we were in Brisbane. We could go for that exercise. It's like WA is the strongest state when it comes to rule lockdown. So we're definitely just staying put in the hotel. And I think they've got a certain training venue we're allowed to go to. But yeah, who knows? I still yet to see what the go is. We're just hoping, especially being from Melbourne, that we can get to WA.
Yes, and then we don't know yet if New Zealand can come across for the Constellation Cup. That hasn't been worked out yet.
Oh, that's just a big question mark at the moment.
Sorry, too many questions.
No, and it's a real thing, isn't it? Because I think where you sit as an athlete is, you want to go to all these states. You want to play netball. Like, that's what I love to do. It's what we all love to do. Everyone loves to watch it. But it's really hard when you're seeing on the news that certain people can't get into their own state because they've had to go for a funeral. So you're really conflicted, because I'm seeing my family were stuck in Sydney and they couldn't get home to WA. And you're seeing how hard it is for everyone else, but it is easier for athletes. It's definitely getting harder. But I definitely feel for everyone out there, and like, know that athletes, as much as we're doing it as well, we feel really hard and bad for everyone else that can't get into their states.
Well, that was the Nitty Gritty, all thanks to Lexis of Berwick. And Braz, I'm going to throw it back over to you because it's time for Brazilliant.
Thank you, B. Well, I've actually got two this week. So my first one, I am going to throw it out to the Giants. So Giants had their awards night, B, which it was a Zoom.
A Zoom.
I'm pretty sure they all got to celebrate it in Brisbane together, which was awesome. But they have a Giants Club Person of the Year. Mm-hmm. And what I loved about this is normally it's one person that gets it, and it's because they've volunteered their time, all their hard work. It's such a big award to get. They gave it to their 5 support staff, so not just one person, the whole 5 that travelled with them. I'm assuming Julie was the one that put this up because she was the only one not in it, but the physios, you know, the video, everything, like just the 5, the manager. So credit to Giants. Just, I think that's a big thing to get, especially because I guess a lot of them are leaving their family. They're travelling to let these girls live their dream. So
yes.
One, congratulations to the Giants. And my second one is, Bianca, it's you. Some exciting news this week.
Whew. Yes.
How are you feeling? Baby B's on the way.
Baby, you can't even really tell, can you? Yes, I know how exciting it has been. I'm, just over 17 weeks now. So sometimes I sit here and I've just got to, like, untighten my jeans a bit, and because it's getting a bit tight. But, yeah, we're super excited. And you know, when we posted about it earlier in the week, I don't think I realised just how overwhelming that would be. And so thank you, everyone, for all of your well wishes and love. But one thing did make me laugh is that everyone referring to me as a reality TV star more than, no one cares about netball. Everyone's just like, oh, the two reality TV people. And I'm like, oh.
The girl from the block. The girl from the block. Well, I've got a question because I'm assuming everyone wants to know, do you know the gender?
I do not know the gender at all. I'm quite happy for the surprise. But we've spoken about this a little bit off air. Do you know what you're having your second one? You don't know.
Surprises, yeah.
Yeah, so I think I'm happy. Mark is not so happy. He would like to know. But
Mark, she's carrying the baby, mate. You don't have a say in it.
I'm like, if you find out, then do I get naming rights or something? I don't know. But at the moment, don't know. But been feeling pretty good, actually. So I feel quite lucky that everything's going to plan so far. So.
Well, you look great. So congratulations. Very exciting.
Thank you. You might have to give me some tips on this parenting thing.
Take it to your makers, girls.
Well, thank you for watching Centre Court. All thanks to TAC. Make safety features a priority in your next car. Visit howsafeisyourcar.com.au. We'll see you again maybe next week. I think we're going to do another show next week.
Yeah, well, you just mentioned that we're having a draft, so...
Oh, yeah, we'll do that too. See you all soon.